Hey guys, it is Saturday. I was just about to say Saturday. Sorry, Wednesday. And today we are again back with the cheap jackknife and the cheap emergency pocket set, or whatever you want to call it, the James Bond set. And today I have a six pin lock. It's only standard pins, but it is a six pinner. I think that is the next step. This is a Chinese copy of a Ruco 600. The bidding is quite flat. I've picked this before on camera some time ago. Come on. Fuku. Yeah. So pretty flat bidding, but it is a six pinner. And yeah, we will see how we will be able to do with this, with these cheap picks. But again, cheap picks, cheap lock, both from China, so shouldn't be that bad. Let's start with the James Bond set. We'll take the tensioner and put it right there, just like on our Ruco 500. Because this have the 500 keyway, but that's pretty much that. Try raking. Good. And I will say it isn't the worst Chinese lock, but it is quite easy anyway. Come on. Let's SPP it, or at least give it a go on it. The feeling is not as good, so I can't really be too sure where I'm at, and because I'm used to a pick with a, well, a hook with a finer tip, but it is still functional. I gotta click there. Think that was pin 3, maybe. And we are open. I hit pin 1 and SPP'd. It hasn't taken long, so let's just quickly try to sip and rock it just for fun. The secret to use these picks, I think, is very light tension so you don't damage the tensioner. It's easy to replace, but still, that is one of the secrets. And rocked open. So, as you can see, it is a quite cheap and easy lock to pick, but it is, however, a six pinner, and I think that is at least something. Come on out. Let's go to the H&H here. I'm just trying to unfold everything here. Let's start with the SPPing so we can get over the thing that probably takes the long first, and then we can try something else. And a tensioner. That should work. Okay, get it back in here. And be sure the focus is as good as it can be. This pick is a little bit easier to feel with, I think. That was maybe pin 4, 3, 2. I think I'm able to feel the pins with this. Pin 6, I got a slight turn. Nothing on 5, 4, 3. Click on 2 and open. So, already there we have the lock open with the H&H as well. Let's try rocking because that was the first pick to pop up. And as you can see, it is quite loose, but I think we're still able to do it. Yeah, still able to open it by rocking even with a loose pick. Let's try this giant half diamond and see if we can sip it with it. Wing. Funny sound. And there we go. And the last thing, of course, raking with the what I think is bad angle for the S-rake. I've told you this before, but I don't like that upward angle on the S-rake. I just like a standard S-rake, but I think we're still able to do this. I would be surprised if not. There we go. So it is an easy lock, but at least we can say we can take the cheapest and worst of the six pinners with both of these tools. And I have another six pinner found next week. On next Saturday, I mean. And also with a bad bidding, but that's a padlock, however. And I will not gut this one because I have done it before on camera. Oops. So I don't think that's necessary. Yeah. So again, these two cheap sets win over the lock, at least this time in any way possible. Alright guys, that's all of this for this Saturday. Thanks for watching. Remember, skill always beats luck, and have a great day.